Dear managers, dear researchers, dear partners, dear Karine Léger, director of Air Paris and all your colleagues, dear members of air quality associations, it's a great honor for the Agence Française de Développement and for me, who is the department in charge of urban development and transport, to welcome you today and to host this international workshop on air quality, and more specifically on monitoring and on micro sensors. As you might know, the French Development Agency is a public financial institution and the French government that implements France foreign air policy, contributing to support the sustainable development goals as well as the climate agenda. To fix ideas, in 2019, we approved about 14 billion euros of financing to governments, to cities, to public and private operators in various sectors such as water, energy, transport, urban development, health, or education. In the country where AFD is working, air pollution issue is becoming more and more crucial, and it is a growing concern of national and local authorities. This is a concern because of the population who is suffering from health problems, and it's also a concern because the attractiveness for investors of their country or of their cities is decreasing. In AFD, we are convinced that air pollution and climate are closely linked with common causes for emissions and also common solutions related to activities such as transport, of course, waste, agricultural practices, heating, all sector AFD is working on. Basically, fighting against air pollution relies on four core pillars. First, awareness of authorities and societies. Second, monitoring and data. Third, financing of projects and policies able to reduce pollution and the assessment of impacts of these actions. In particular, monitoring is key, especially in the country where AFD is working, where there is an important lack of data. Monitoring means actually getting reliable data to inform and to build real public policies on air pollution. It means also maintaining monitoring networks, supporting local knowledge, and providing capacity building for the implementation of long-term air quality policies. In this regard, microsensors are now a big challenge. They are rather cheap, innovative, and then attractive for countries with financial constraints. However, and this is one of the purposes of today, the air quality community has to promote the most adequate and best performing devices. It is key for our foreign partners, for the private providers, and for an institution like AFD providing technical and financial supports. In this context, AFD is engaging growing efforts towards air quality improvement. And we had the pleasure to sign last December a 2-year partnership with Air Paris in order to propose actions and financing to our foreign partners. And I really thank Air Paris for that. To conclude, and on behalf of the French Development Agency, I wish you a very fruitful day dedicated to that huge challenge of air quality. Thank you very much.
Good morning. It's a great pleasure and a great honor for me to be here today. I first like to thank a lot of people. First of all, AFD for hosting this event and for their very strong support, both for the challenge but also for the workshop. And among them, especially Karine, Liz, and Stéphane, who really helped us with this workshop and with the challenge, as well as with cooperation agreement that we have signed together in order to improve air quality across the world. It's a big challenge. I also would like to thank our partners, like researchers and company, who also supported the challenge and the workshop, Veolia, EDF, ENGIE, and the DIM QI2. the speakers, of course, and we came. You are coming from a long way to here to Paris. It has been a bit complicated due to the strikes, and we really thank you to have managed to come again here for the workshop today, despite the displacement of the date. I also would like to thank the AirLab partners, Air Paris team, which has been deeply involved in this event and in the challenge, as well as you, public, for coming to this event. Maybe just a word about Air Paris for those who do not know us. In France, air pollution is monitored by an independent agency. It's meant by the law, and it's quite specific because those agency, they have an administration board gathering all the stakeholders. You have the state, the authorities, the local authorities, industries and economical player, and experts and NGOs. They all have the same weight, and this is meant to have around the table all the organizations dealing with air pollution, either because they emit the pollutant into the atmosphere, because they have to deal with air pollution, or because they represent the civil society and they breathe with air pollution. In France, Paris has been set up 40 years ago. We are in charge of monitoring, informing for the whole region. And one key issue for us is transparency. It's transparency, but it's also quality of the information we provide. At the origin of this workshop and the origin of this challenge of microsensor, there were two big questions. Despite the improvement of air pollution, it's air quality, what we breathe, it's still not satisfactory. We have still 1 million inhabitants exposed to air pollution higher than the regulation for NO2, for instance. And we need to improve air quality further and really faster. Then, at the same time, there was also booming development of low-cost sensors. And there were a lot of interest, but also a lot of questions. And this was a common issue in many countries, and that's also why AFT was interested in this discussion. To improve air pollution, you have different different mitigation measures. You can work, you need scientific evidence, forecast, test scenarios. As you need to monitor this air pollution, you need technical solution, and that's where innovation plays a key role. You need regulation like tax system and incentive, and you also need to raise awareness and to change the behavior. You need to involve different kind of stakeholders, the authorities, scientists, industries, media, citizens, and NGOs. And based on these findings, that's why we decided with different partners to develop an air lab. This air lab is meant to go further and further in improving air pollution, in air quality, and by stimulating and implementing innovation. And this is based on an ecosystem of different stakeholders, a lot of them being in the room today. Authorities, industries, NGOs, startups, large companies, all of this ecosystem is meant to stimulate innovation, both regarding monitoring, but also regarding remediation and solution that could help to improve the situation. Now, as far as the microsensors are concerned, it's really a booming interest, but it's not really a new topic. There is an increase in the research program those past years. There is a great interest in the media, the public, NGO, and authorities, but it has been around for quite a long period of time. We started to work on them maybe 10 years ago. This booming development across the world is also enhanced because there are new technology like the IoT, big data, intelligent AI. There is a social demand to make its own measurements. And there is an internal context with a rising concern regarding air pollution across the world, and especially in large cities. Those microsensors, they provide a great promises in principle to provide fast and easy solution to be installed, to increase the spatial and the temporal coverage of the measurements, to improve the modeling resolution. We are looking for them to help identificate hotspot area for information in different kind of environments, for information regarding the personal exposure, to help raise awareness and change behavior, and to reduce the cost of a monitoring network. However, There are also a lot of questions, reliability, overall cost, data access. That's why, with on one hand the lab and different innovative projects to improve air quality, and on the other hand, this question about microsensors, there were different projects in air lab based on microsensors for indoor monitoring, for indoor air quality with Veolia and ICAT, for urban furniture with EDF and Citelum, for citizen participation with the municipality of Paris, for monitoring and remediation technologies with Urban Lab and ECO, and all of these projects, they had one piece dedicated to microsensors. And we decided together with the partners that we would really need an evaluation of these microsensors, not one project by one project, but why not making an overall evaluation of the microsensors for the different kind of use. That's how we ended up with the first challenge for microsensors in 2018. The objective was to reply to the question of the stakeholders, to help them choose the technology that best fits to their needs, but also to highlight the quality of the devices and to raise also the pathway for improvement. All of this was based on independent testing with a panel of scientists, experts in air pollution, experts in monitoring. We have tested 30 commercial solutions for different kinds of use and according to 41 parameters. That's how we started 1 year ago. This year, it's a new challenge. This time it's an international edition because this question of microsensors is not only a question for the Paris region, but it's really an international question, also for the companies that are involved in developing those microsensors. And we also wanted to provide insight and feedback from different experiments of stakeholders that have been using those microsensors. And that's why the challenge is also working together with the workshop. I wish you a very pleasant day. I hope this discussion will be very fruitful for you, and do not and also make sure that you have a look at the exhibition outside, because the different companies that are here in the room, they also have prepared exhibition showing and demonstrating the devices. Thank you very much.